So, good afternoon, everyone. Today, we are going to learn a very interesting lesson where you have to learn how to be a good host. Host means what? The one who is receiving the guests. The guests are coming to their house and you have to give proper care of them. You have to serve them. Okay, that is called the hospitality. Let us see with the help of this example lesson that how can you be a good host. And as well as there will be some points will be given as how can you be the good guest also. When you go to someone, you have to be a good, okay? You have to behave in a good manners. You don't have to just go and touch everywhere. Nowadays, it is very, very important that in this pandemic situation, you don't have to go as a guest to anyone, or you do not allow someone to be the guest, or you cannot be the host. Why? Because it's a time where we are facing a very virus problem, that is coronavirus, and we don't welcome our guests. Yes or no? Everyone is locked under their house and we are just having the person, the quarantine. You see in the situation where we are quarantined and we cannot welcome the guest and we cannot go as a guest. So just try to understand when the corona will go, this coronavirus will go, we have the vaccination, at that time the people will be very much attracted towards to meet each other. Yes or no? So when they came to your house, how can you welcome them? How can you greet them? Or if you are going to someone's house, how can you just be a good person, a good guest for them? Okay? You have to take some of the precautions. Let us try to understand with the help of this lesson, as well as we will add something that how can we take the precautions, the sanitizations and using the mask. Everything should be followed. Yes or no? The addition point will be there. Let us try to understand the lesson first. Then I will tell you how to be a good host and a good guest after this coronavirus is gone. Okay, let us start reading and I will explain as well as. Yes, let us see. The first para is the lesson name number 19. Be a good host and guest. We all love to get together with our friends and have fun. Yes or no? We all love to come together, friends and have the fun. For example, as a student, as a child, you love to celebrate your birthday, the surprise parties, everything that gives us the happiness, that gives us the close relation. We're fond of each other. We like our favorite dishes even better when we share them with our friends. The sharing and caring has been taught us from the child and we love that. Whenever, whatever it is, do we have a favorite dish? We do not have when we are on the picnic, when we are just having our recess time. Every time we do like to share our tiffins, every time, most of the time, our lower standard students, what they do, they just come to us and they share their tiffins. They like to give us. At least one bite can be shared with the teacher or the friend. It's a thing which shows us the like. Yes, the bonding between ourselves. In short, we all love a party. Yes, a small, big party, it is part, just a sharing and caring is called the enjoying themselves. We enjoy with our friends. So we all love a party. Now let us see, you may have attended parties or you may even have given some. You may have given some. What do you think makes a good party? Okay, many times you must have arranged the parties, many times you must have gone to attend the birthday parties, the parties, other parties. But what do you think? What makes a good party? Let us see whether they are the expensive gifts, fancy clothes, costly decorations, rich food, yes, these are such things which gives the party a good look, gives the it creates the attention of the guest. Yes or no? So all these things, expensive gift, fancy clothes, costly decorations, rich food, everything gives us the pleasure or gives us the attraction to celebrate that party. If you are a host, these are the things that you should remember to do. Okay? These are the things you should remember. Now let us have a party. One example is given and the family is arranging a party. Okay? The family is arranging the party. Let us see how do they have or they arrange that. Okay? Let's have a party. Let's have a surprise party for grandpa. Okay, that she is about to celebrate. She gave the idea to the parent that give a surprise party for the grandpa. So to this, what do you have to do? You don't have to just give an order. You cannot order your parents that I want the party. But you can just consult with your parents. You just have to sit with your parents and just have a consultation. Consultation means have a discussion session. Okay, your family first and see whether they like the idea or not. Because the parents must have to arrange the money. They must have to see that whether they have the time or not. If they are working, both the parents are working, they have to just arrange accordingly. So consult with your parents. They will help you to choose a suitable time, date, place, menu, etc. Okay? These all the things will be arranged by your parents. They will help you to do this. Okay? If it is a birthday party for the grandpa, you just have to see when it is having a birthday. And you just have to see the date also. Everything should be accordingly managed. Make a list of people you wish to invite to the party. Okay? When your parents will agree to have the party, what you are going to do? You are just going to see that the suitable time and date will be there. Accordingly, you have to send the invitation. If you have a long time, you can give them the letter. If it is a short period of time for the party, what you can do? You can just call your to whom you want to wish to call. Okay, you want to invite, you can directly have a call with them. Okay, so these are the two things. You can write a letter, you can send the call. But as I have taught you the formal and informal letter, here also two things are being mentioned where you write a formal invitation and as well as you can write an informal invitation. Let us see what that. Send the invitations well in advance. Okay, as I have told you, you have to send the invitation well in advance. You have to see that whether you have a long period of time for the party or a short period. Accordingly, you have to send an invitation. You may extend an invitation orally, or you may send a written invitation. Orally in the sense you can have a call, or else you can send the invitation in a written format. Make sure your invitation includes all the necessary information. Okay? You just don't have to invite that person that we are having a party. You just have to come. No. Accordingly, we just have to give a necessary information. First, you just have to ask or inquire for them. After that, you can ask for the party, that there is the invitation for the party and for whom you have arranged that party. After that, you can give the date, time and your address so that they can reach to the house on time. Okay? Everything should be mentioned in your invitation. Who is inviting to whom? Okay, in that invitation, you have to mention who is inviting as well as to whom you are sending that invitation. The occasions why you are giving the party. What is the point? That you have to mention what is the occasions, whether it is a retirement party, whether it is a birthday party or welcoming party, why you are giving or hosting this party should be given. The reason should be given. When and where it will be held. Okay. The time and the place should be mentioned. The venue. It is called the venue of the invitation. Whether you are celebrating that in the your own house, whether you have allotted a big auditorium or a hall, everything should be mentioned. What day and what time, what place, everything should be mentioned clearly. Okay, let us see the two examples given over here, that is a formal invitation as well as an informal invitation. Now, to whom we write the formal invitation? The person who is elder from us. Okay, if a child, the person from your family, if he is elder and you want to invite them, you have to write a formal invitation. You cannot be a very friendly. You just have to have some formalities. Yes or no? These formalities should be followed. Let us see the letter which is written on 13, 12, 15. This is not the date when you are celebrating the party, but the date when the person is writing an invitation. Dear Madhu uncle. Now the letter is written to the Madhu uncle. We have arranged a surprise party for Daddy on the 21st of December. Wait a minute. 21st of December, his birthday. Okay. Why do they write an invitation? Because it was a birthday of the daddy. We have arranged a surprise party for the daddy on 21st of December, his birthday. I will be very happy if you can come to our house at about 6 p.m. What did he say? I will be very happy if you come to our house at 6 p.m. The date is given, the time is also given, and the reason is also mentioned that they are having a birthday party for the daddy. Okay. We have also called a few other close relatives. What did she mention? That only we have called some of the a few other close relatives are being called. Yours lovingly, Mandar. Okay, so in a very short, they have mentioned the invitation. Nowadays, we have a printing invitation cards also. Everything, the format will be same. The venue, address, and the time is being mentioned. The family member's name, as well as the phone number, is also being mentioned. You just have to write to whom you are sending the printed invitation. And it's to you that you have to send it. Okay. Now let us see the formal, informal invitation. Hi Sona, I'm so excited. A surprise party. I'm so excited for a surprise party for Grandpa on 21st December at our house. What? It's very informal. She's not greeting. She's not giving a particular information, but directly she mentioned as in hi, hello. Okay. So she said that I'm so excited for the party, a surprise party arranged for Grandpa. Again, the same date is being mentioned. That is 21st of December at our house. Do come at 6 in the evening. Don't forget. It's a very informal way to tell the person who is very close to you. Give this message to uncle and auntie. What did she say that? As a friend, you are writing this letter. So what did she say? Not only you is being invited, but your parents are also invited for the party. Give this message to uncle and auntie. don't let grandpa know. Is it a surprise party? That's why don't tell my grandpa about the party. It's a very surprise. Written by your Kedar. Okay, so both the letters gave you the idea how you are going to deal with the party as a surprise. Okay. Now, choose a menu that your guest will enjoy. You just have to see which menu will be suitable. How can you just make the person happy by giving the food? Remember the story of the fox and the crane. As a good host, you should consider your guest preference first. Okay? So what did he mentioned over here? You just have to remember the story of the fox and the crane. That in that story, the fox invited the crane for the party, and he was not just welcoming the crane, but he gave some of the situations where the crane was facing some problems. Okay, so like that should not be happened. As you are a host of that party, you should welcome them with a great hearted. You are most welcome that you can enjoy the party and have the food. After that, okay, after you have decided the menu accordingly with the according to the guest, considering the guest preference, after that, chalk out a program. Will you begin with the games or a music? When will food be served? Okay, so what do you have to do? You just have to plan. Okay, the party start at 6 a.m. After that, the grandpa will be given a surprise. He will enter in the room. The lights will be off. Everything should be planned accordingly. Okay, when grandpa will enter, these things will happen. He will cut the cake. The gifts will be given. The pictures clicking will be there. After that, the game session or the music session for the children or for the person who came or the guest who came. After that, when you are going to serve the food, it should be accordingly the time. If the guests have been arrived on the 6 or 7, the food will be served within 1 hour. Okay, the snacks or the starter should be provided. Everything should be planned accordingly. Do you want any decorations? How will they be done? Okay. So what you have to see? You just have to see that if you want a decoration, you just have to plan accordingly. The grandpa should not be at the home whole day. You have to decorate the house. You have to arrange for the party, the cakes and everything. Okay. And plan accordingly. Divide the work among each other. The grandmother is going to bake the cake. The mother is going to have some food. The father is going to decorate the house. You are going to help your father for blowing the balloons, for decorating the tables and the halls. Everything should be divided accordingly. Now, once you have planned the above details, okay, everything has been planned. After that, you can work out how the various tasks can be done. You have to see that the various tasks, that games and everything should be planned accordingly. Who will help you to do each of them? As I have told you, you have to divide the work. Okay, so if you have distributed the works among each other, it will not create them. You just have to write it down that these are the work done by grandma. These are the works done by my mother, the father, and I'm going to help to whom. So everything be planned accordingly. Now, on the day of the party. Okay, let us see what happens on the day when the party is being started. The grandpa is being entered in the room, and you can see the facial expressions of the grandpa. What did he was just being surprised. Wow, great, what a surprise. Every after every single word, you can see the exclamation. That means he was got a surprise. He was very happy. You must be ready before your guest. Okay. So as your grandpa, when he entered, you should be ready with your surprise and everything. You should be ready for your party as well as. After that, your decorations, food preparations should be ready before the people arrive. Before the 6 p.m., what you can do? You can just complete your final touch-up. The final preparation for your decoration, for your food preparations, and everything should be get ready. As your parents will be arriving, you should welcome them standing on the door, or you can welcome them by just having a standing in front of them. Okay, that is called the welcoming of the guest. It should happen that the guests are coming and the host or the people who is giving a party is not at the home. This thing should not be happened. So be ready to welcome the guest. You must greet all your guests when they arrive. As I have told you, you can welcome them. You have to greet them. It's a good evening. Hi, hello, how are you? Welcome. Every greeting word should be used to welcome your guest. If they don't know one another, you must introduce them. The introduction should be given that this is my brother, this is my grandparent, this is my mother and the father. Yes, welcome, hi, hello. They will shake their hands. Everything should be accordingly. Have to plan in your mind. You must have seen in the many of the movies and the films what you may have seen. Okay. So, greeting the guests is important. You should see that all your guests are comfortable and happy. All your guests should be comfortable and happy. They should not feel alone. The party should keep on moving. You should not stand in one place and just watching the people. No, you just have to welcome them. You have to talk to them. You have to introduce each other. You have to make them comfort. You have to make them happy. The music should be on. The music should be according to the time. Everything should be planned accordingly. You should serve the food politely. Make sure that everyone is served what they want. Nowadays, we have a buffet system. They can go to that counter and they can have their food. They can serve by themselves. But if you are serving to your guests, how do you? You just have to be very polite. You have to make sure that everyone is being served. No one is being sitting as it is. Their plate should be full. Okay. These all are the things you have to see when you are hosting the party. Okay. The grandparent or the grandpa's birthday party is being arranged very nicely with the help of the children as well as the parents. Everyone you can see is interested for the party. Okay. These are the things you have to see. If you are holding the party games, make sure that everyone gets a chance to participate and enjoy. Okay? So, many games are being played in the parties like Simon Says, Musical Chair, everything. So, when you are having that game or your party is being holding that game, you have to make sure that everyone is going to get the chance. Only the special people is not being attracted, but everyone should be given a proper chance. Here are some common party games. Simon Says, have two hands up. Okay, here you can see this is the game. Simon says, this is musical chair, the person who should sit backward to the people. They have to run accordingly, and when the music stops, you have to sit in one place. Okay? So, the two games. After that, you have whispers, hot and cold guessing game. After that, you have Chades, that is Hindi or English, four words, that is the Damshiraj. Like it's like a Damshiraj game. After that, it's a very interesting game which we have played in our school also. Pin the hole on the donkey. First have to attach a proper tail to that donkey. Okay? After that, a most useful game, that is the treasure hunt. You have to hide the gift somewhere and you have to give some directions. That is called the treasure hunt. These all are very useful games for the party. Okay. After that, when it is time for the guest to leave, okay, the party is being over, you have to say goodbye to each of them properly. What are you going to do? You are going to say goodbye. You just have to be very polite, happy, and you have to send them off. Okay. Most important of all, help clean up after a party. As it was your plan to have a party for your parents, it's a party for your parents. They have arranged for you. It was your wish. What is your duty? That after finishing the party or after the party, you have to help your parents in the cleanup. You can just collect the decoration work for the next party, keep it in arranged manner, pack them, just keep the cake in fridge if it is left over, help your mother for cleaning, just your grooming and cleaning up the dishes, everything can be properly arranged. Okay, these all are the things you have to keep in your mind. Now, as you have hosted the party, you are welcoming the parents. Yes, you are welcoming the parents. Let us see some of the tips when you go to someone's party. As a guest, you have to be very formal. You have to formalities. Let us see what are they. Please acknowledge that you have received the invitation and let your host know whether or not you will attend the party. Okay? When you receive the invitation, you just have to give a returned message. Yes, I will be there for the party, or if for any purpose, I will not be able to come for the party. Yes or no should be acknowledged or should be informed to the host. As well as see that you have received the invitation. Don't just follow the whispers. Someone have told you that, yes, I have been invited for this party. And without the invitation, don't go. If you have a proper invitation, then only you can go for the party. If you are choosing present for your host, okay, as a birthday gift, as a gift for the anything, if you are choosing that gift, think well about what he or she will like. A thoughtful gift is appreciated more than an expensive one. The gift should not be expensive, but it should be according to that person's like. If you are going for the grandpa's party, what you can have? You can take a kurta, you can have the book, you can give him a stick according to his like or his need. Don't just go with the thing that it's a party of grandpa and you have taken a small children's toy or something. It should not be happened. Okay? So see that the person accordingly you have to choose or you have to thought for that gift. It should not be expensive, but it should be useful. Remember to remove the price tag or the label from the gift. What? You have to remove the price tag. Why do we remove the price tag? Because we don't want to hurt that person. Okay? Sometimes what happens, a cheap gift or the expensive gift can be touched to that person's hand, heart. So remove the price tag. It is not polite to let your host know how much you have spent on the gift. Yes or no? You don't have to again and again say, hey, my gift is very expensive. This is of 1,000 rupees. I have brought for you very expensive. In my birthday party, you have to give me the same price gift. No, you don't have to again and again mention your gift. Just go politely. Just give your gift, wish or greet that person and leave it. Okay? Don't show off. After that, you have to wrap the gift well. If possible, decorate the wrapping yourself. Okay? You just have to wrap that gift. On the day of party, what you are going to do? You are going to be very punctual. If it is being told that party is on the 6 p.m., you have to reach that there by 6 or 6:30, not more than that. Why? Because we, as the Indians, we follow the Indian time. Many people, if 6 p.m. is given, you reached at the house by 7 or 7:30. It should not be happened. You should be very punctual. Reach on time. If there is any work to be done, offer to help. Okay? You can go. Don't as it is sit for the party. You have to ask them, yes, can I help you for this? Can you want my help? Everything should be asked. Be friendly with the other guests. The introduction session has been done. You are now being a friendly person. So treat them as a friendly. Don't treat them as a stranger. Take part in the programs and the games. If there are any, willingly. Okay? According to your willing or according to the situation, you have to take part in that program. Don't just treat it as a stranger. Okay, enjoy the party and make the host that he is given a nice party. After that, you have to appreciate the food and the decoration honestly. What? You have to appreciate the food. Don't waste the food. Take only as much as you want. Now what happens? Some of the people, they go for the party, they take full all the dishes, overeating, and they do not eat. They throw it in the dustbin. This thing should not be happened. Don't waste your food. Okay? When it is time for you to leave, approach your host and say goodbye. What? You just have to say yes. It was a very nice party. You have arranged a very nice thing. The party was very interesting and very happy thing. And you have to say goodbye and you can leave. Okay. Later on, let your host know either personally or in return how much you enjoyed the party. Okay. As a guest, you can ask, okay, you can send a written format or personally also you can tell that yes, I have enjoyed the party. The party was well prepared, well arranged. You have to give appreciation. At the end, the success of a party should be measured by the goodwill and the friendship it creates. Be you a host or a guest, do all you can to boost it. Okay? What is the message given over here? That the success of the party, it should be measured by the goodwill. How nicely they have arranged the party. It should not be in the revenge. It should not be according to the only to give the party as it is. But it should create the friendship amongst the people. Closing, get together. It is called get together. Means the introduction of the unknown person to the unknown. And giving a happiness, sharing the happiness. Okay. Now, your host or the guest should be all you can to do for the boosted. Boosted means as you have to give them the energy that yes, I can arrange the party. My party is being well done and I have given the happiness. I have shared the happiness. That is called giving energy, boosting the people. Okay? And this is all about the lesson. How can you be a good guest as well as you can be a good host. Okay? Just observe the other's party. Learn something new. See that you will be having some kind of the things. Don't imitate or don't just give a bad impression on the others. The impression should be created amongst that. Okay? This is all about can be the good host and the guest. Okay? I hope you all must have understood the lesson. It was very nicely being told that how can you arrange the party as well as how can you go for the party. Okay? Nowadays, as I have told you in the first also, the coronavirus period, what we have to? We have to follow the social distancing. We have to use the mask, sanitization, and everything should be accordingly taking some other precautions or the safety measures. Okay? According to follow the safety measures. Everything should be accordingly and plan your party. So